today? You want to hear, anybody here want to hear from God today about their life?
Amen.
Amen. Anybody here? Say, Lord, speak to me, Lord.
Lord, speak to me, Lord.
Hallelujah. 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 Today, we're going to talk about the promise and its fulfillment. If anyone has an offering, here, you mind passing this? I'm not like a 15. You're on fire, brother. Amen. I don't do a 15-minute spiel on giving, okay? God loves a cheerful giver. If you have and you desire to give today, give. Amen. He'll bless you. He don't need your money. Amen. But he wants to see if you are willing to give because he's given everything. Amen. Hallelujah. Man, you know what? Lord, forgive me for even having that thought. Even though it's a good thought, forgive me for having that thought. Amen. Because not all good thoughts are God thoughts. Can I get an amen?
Amen?
Now, God is good. His word is good. Amen. God is the word. Amen. But not every good thing is a God thing. Amen. Eve did what seemed good. So evidently she had to have a seemingly good thought in her head in order to do it. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Man, I'm so excited for this Faith, Hope, and Love conference we're having. 24th, 25th, 26th, I'll have flyers by next Sunday. Went and met with the two pastors who will be coming here and ministering. Last year we had a wonderful faith. It's called Faith, Hope, and Love. God did miracles, signs, wonders. But the greatest thing is salvation. Amen? Can I get somebody to pray with Brother Jonathan? Amen? You good now? Yeah, he's going to use you. Hallelujah. Come on, everybody put your hand forward to the offering today. You know, whether you could give, okay, and you did, hallelujah. We pray that God's going to bless that. If you couldn't give, amen, and you had a desire, I want you to pray that God give you the ability to give. Amen? This is what it's about, amen? Go ahead and pray, guys. Go ahead and pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 See, Jonathan, I'm just going to speak for Jonathan real quick. God has him at a point of stepping out of his comfort zone. Amen.
Amen.
He's getting out that boat. Amen. Next time he's going to pray a little louder. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
I'm a man of many faces. Amen. I'm sure Jesus was too. Now get them kids up out of here. Bye. Adios. Parents, please walk your children back there. Make sure they get no. Jade Rose. Let the parents take their children back there, please. Thank you. Some people, out of the loving kindness of their heart, they just want to help. Amen. Anybody here just want to help? You just want to help. Sometimes you get in the way of God wanting to help. Can I get an amen? We got to know when it's best. Hallelujah. Taking every thought into captivity. Hallelujah. Today I want to talk to you just real quick, go over the announcements. Listen, I'm scatterbrained, but I believe in Jesus and I love him. Amen. And it's hard for me to do like church stuff because I just want to praise God and I want to minister the word. Amen. But then you got all these other things, right? Like announcements. Amen. And I have to start being obedient to God. Amen. Even those little things he wants me to do. Amen. Because it's the little things that mean most to everybody else. Amen. So if you don't have a calendar, they're in the back. We got Sunday service at 1 p.m. of course. Monday night we feed the homeless, 7 p.m. If you are a member of the church, we do request that you fast with us from sunup to sundown. We fast together. Those who die together live together. Amen?
Amen.
Now if you got some type of medical problem and you can't fast, okay, pray. Amen?
Amen.
Pray that God will heal you so that you can fast. Amen?
Amen.
Don't pray that he'll heal you so you're better. Pray that he'll heal you so you can do his will. Amen.
Right.
Some of us praying for the wrong things.
That's
Amen.
Right.
Starting this Friday, Bible study at 7 p.m. I know I skipped Wednesday service, but we're teaching on Wednesdays in regards to the Holy Spirit. Sundays I'm ministering on the Holy Spirit. Friday at 7 p.m. we are teaching about how to pray. Even the disciples asked Jesus, how do we pray? Amen? There's an order in prayer. Amen?
Yeah, that's right.
And so, do you want prayer? Anybody here pray? Anybody here just find yourself praying? Do you want your prayers answered?
Hallelujah.
Anybody want prayers answered here? Amen. If you want prayers answered, put your hand up for me real quick. Okay. Well, God's going to be teaching us on how to pray and get our prayers answered by the Word of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen? Amen. That should be exciting. Amen?
Amen.
But it's going to teach you what not to pray for, too. Amen?
Amen?
My wife prayed. I went to Africa, right? Caught malaria, cerebral malaria. I prayed. I said, Lord, because we flew back to Dallas for a day to get on another plane to go to Central America. And I said, Lord, do you want me to go to Honduras? He said, yeah, I want you to go. Right? And when I got to Honduras, I was there for 2 days, sick in bed. And I got to the point where all of my organs shut down, except for my heart, okay, and my brain. And my wife's prayer was, Lord, I wish I could be there for him through that. Now, that's a pretty decent prayer, amen. That's what every wife or loved one would want, amen, for their loved one. So you know what the Lord allowed? He allowed me to come back and still be sick with malaria, amen, so she could go through that with me, amen.
Hallelujah.
And I'm totally healed today, amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Now, I want to share this with you. I serve God. I love God, okay? I fall short in my walk with my attitude and things in my heart. Amen? I've learned to overcome the fleshly desires, but I still sin in thought. Amen?
Amen.
We can overcome the flesh. Amen? That's obedience. But the willingness is getting the thoughts. Amen? Jesus said if you already think about a woman in the wrong way, you've already committed adultery. Amen? For many of us, and I believe in this place today, we've overcame the power of the flesh. Amen? In the outward, I've cleaned the inside, the outside of the cup. Amen? But the thoughts, the inside of the cup, guess what God is working on in this season? Amen? That's what the Holy Spirit does. Amen? It doesn't look at the outside. It looks at the inside. What's inside? Amen? Some of you guys be like, man, why is he talking to me like this, man? Well, because I see what's on the inside. I've been born again. Amen? I see the Spirit at work. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's either holy or it's unholy. Amen?
Thank you, Jesus.
There's no in between. We're either dedicated to serving God or we're not dedicated to serving God. Amen?
Amen.
We have to make that choice. Amen? Yes and no. Some of us are on the no today, amen? Well, I'm going to pray and I'm going to believe that. Guess what? By the end of this sermon, you're going to be on the yes. Amen?
Amen.
Some of you on the yes, and maybe we'll get three yeses out of you. Amen?
Amen.
It doesn't matter where you are. He says, come as you are. Amen?
Amen?
Open up your hearts and receive what I have for you. Amen? Is that why we're here today? Can I get an amen?
Amen?
I don't care where you are. I don't care what you're dealing with. I don't care. None of that stuff matters to me. None of that stuff matters to me. It matters to God, though. Amen?
Amen?
It matters to God because He died. He sent His one and only Son, Jesus, to die on the cross to give you power, which is grace. Amen?
Amen.
Not only to forgive you, but to empower you and say, get behind me, Satan. Amen?
Amen.
I think a lot of us forget that little kick. Amen? I used to watch Jordan with North Carolina. He's a Tar Heel. Come on, you got to kick that thing away from you. Amen? Some of y'all need to kick Satan's... Better not say that in church. Amen? I wouldn't say it at home either. Amen? But you got to start kicking Satan's behind. Through prayer. Through praise. And through allowing the Holy Ghost to teach you and lead you in all of your ways. Amen? That's the only way. Say the promise.
The promise.
And its fulfillment.
And its fulfillment.
I've always spoken to the congregation and the people of God by saying, how many of y'all had a prophecy spoken over your life? You've gone to church or you've met someone and they say, this is going to happen in your life. Anybody here? All right, 3, 4, 5. Well, I pray I'll be the first one and it come to fulfillment in your life. Amen?
Amen.
But there's a time between the time of a promise and the time of a fulfillment. Amen?
Amen?
The difference is preparation time. That's what's in the middle. Amen? A prophecy is a promise of God. Amen? It's a word spoken over your life that this is going to happen. The time of that prophecy to come into fulfillment is time. Amen? And in that time, are we believing, okay, what was spoken over our life that we're going to prepare to receive it? Amen? I'm not going to give my kid $1 million if he spends all his money on Legos.
That's right.
That's my kid back there, amen? God's not going to give you $1 million if you're not using it to advance his kingdom. If you got 10 bucks and you can't give him one, he's not going to give you 100 because you ain't going to give him 10. Amen? God works it backwards. It's the other way. Amen? The woman who had 2 mites versus the rich man who gave everything. Okay? The 2 mites is faith. Amen? It's impossible to please God without faith. Do we need faith, though, when we got the Holy Ghost? No, then we can begin to trust. Hallelujah. Trust the Spirit. Test the Spirit. Amen? Trust God. This is the promise and the fulfillment. Amen? The promise is the Holy Ghost. The fulfillment is us trusting God. Amen? Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus, I thank you for this word. I pray that it go forth and not return void. Help me to teach it, Father. Help me to tear it apart, God. And Father, to feed it as needed to each and every person here. But Father, you know me. You know how excited I get about your word. You know how I want to stick to this word when you want me to be led by the Holy Spirit and how I want to be led by the Holy Spirit when you want me to lead to the word. But Father, I just pray that you get me gone so I can minister to your people today, God. In Jesus' mighty name, and the church say,
amen.
So the Lord has promised rivers of living water to quench man's spiritual thirst. There's a terminology in this world today called thirsty. Amen? These young kids, what do they used to say? What? Or you thirsty, right? Amen? What's that mean? Don't mean nothing good. Hallelujah. So that means that we can be thirsty for 2 things in this world. The things of God or the things of the world. Amen?
Amen.
Jesus said, I'll make you rivers of flowing water. Amen? To quench the spiritual thirst. Amen? Some of us are still living for the flesh, coming to God, asking Him to fulfill that longing, but it's really not. Amen? We must live a crucified life. Hallelujah?
Amen.
It's not about us. When we've given our life to Jesus, we're done. Amen? It's God, I've lived my life for so long for the desires that I wanted, for the things I wanted, and now I'm placing those things on the cross, and I'm living the crucified life now in the power of the life-giving Spirit. Amen?
Amen.
That's how it should be. If it's not, then guess what? God is speaking this to us for a reason. He's speaking this to us so we can say, Lord, forgive me. Forgive me for not doing this. Forgive me for believing I can do it any other way. Why would He send Jesus on the cross to condemn you? He says, he doesn't preach this word that we would be condemned. He don't preach this word that we could get offended. He doesn't preach the word of God so that we would be hurt. He preaches the word so that we could say, God, you're right and I'm wrong. You are creator. You created all things, God. You created me before I was in my mother's womb. It was the breath that brought me to life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We have to believe this. I want to start off with Psalms 139. Psalms 139. I'm just going to read this real quick. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Anyone here believe the Word of God? Anybody here? Come on now. You believe the Word. Amen? So I'm going to read the Word to you and I'm going to let you know what it says. Oh Lord, thou hast searched me and know me. Do you know that God searches you? And he knows you? Do you believe that? Do you believe that, guess what? You're the ketchup jug, amen? And when there's just a little bit left and he squeezes it out, guess what? He wants him to come out, amen? But if there's mustard coming out, guess what? It just doesn't look right. Hallelujah. He knows you. He knows if you got mustard or ketchup inside of you. And no, we should not mix them. Hallelujah. Maybe you like them both on the hot dog, and that's fine, but they still need to be separate. Amen. A fresh water doesn't spit out salt water. We can't be mixed. Hallelujah. We have to be yes or no for God. He knows us. Say, Lord, you know me.
Lord, you know me.
Thou knowest my down sitting and mine uprising. Thou understandest my thoughts afar off. You know what I stand for, and you know what I really lax on, amen? You know what I believe and what I don't believe, amen?
Amen.
Some of us is sitting on Christ instead of standing with him, amen?
Amen.
We got to stand with him, not just sit down, hallelujah. He wants you to come sit down here to message so you can go out there and stand for him, hallelujah.
Amen.
He says, thou compassest my path and my lying down. You compass it. What's a compass do? It tells you what direction you're going. Amen? That Holy Ghost makes that thing move. Guess what? Tells you where north is, where up is, where Jesus is. Hallelujah. And how to get to him. Amen? I love the movie Pirates of the Caribbean. You want to know why? Because Johnny Depp got a compass that doesn't point north. It points to a treasure. Amen? My compass doesn't point north. It points to Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit, what God has placed within me, guess what he does? He points to Jesus. That's why we need the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Some of us, maybe we don't have it and you desire the Holy Ghost. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Man, I want this thing that you're talking about. Man, can I get this thing? Yes. Guess what? Give your heart to Jesus
amen.
Christ.
Amen.
Give it to him. Amen. And don't take it back when things don't go your way. It's called an Indian giver. Amen?
Amen.
No one likes Indian givers. You're made in God's image and his likeness. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Anybody got brothers or sisters here? Right? Hey, come on now. Here. Let me get that back. Why are we doing that to God, though? It's not funny. It is funny, but it's not funny. Right? It's not funny. We give God our problems, but as soon as they manifest in our life again, we try to handle them instead of let him direct us through them.
Amen.
Using the compass of the Holy Ghost. Amen?
Amen.
He knoweth our thoughts from afar. He knows what we're going to think. He knows that when we get to the situation, our thoughts, so he says, I don't think that.
Amen.
Think good things.
Yes.
Think pure things.
Yes.
Think things that are lovely. Amen?
Amen.
Think positive. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There was this wise woman that I know. I met her a while ago, but I met her again this morning. And she told me, she got in my van this morning. She says, you know what? I was speaking life. I was speaking life. I was speaking life. I was speaking life. And I said, man, Lord, thank you for life. Hallelujah. Thank you that I can speak the word over my life. I can speak your promises. Thank you, wise woman. You're awesome. Amen. We may not have it all together, but we got the wisdom of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
We got to learn to trust in God. Hallelujah.
That's right.
It says, thou hast, okay? For there is not a word, okay, in my tongue, but, O Lord, thou knowest it all together. And I'm going to stop there. I just want you to let, and if you have a desire to go home and read Psalms 139, I pray that I spark that desire in you. Amen. Wow. Just those four verses, man, it just let me know, man. And the Holy Ghost here. Well, my blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness for what? They shall be filled. And your hunger and thirst for righteousness got to be outside of these four walls. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Coming to church doesn't make us righteous. That is an act of our righteousness. Amen?
Amen.
It's our faith that gets us here, but works won't get us to heaven. Amen? But I want to get to the message. Can I get an amen? Well, he's like, man, you've already given us a message. Let's turn to John chapter 14, verse 16. I want to start in the gospel. Hallelujah. It says, and I will pray to the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever. Verse 17. Even the... Somebody say that. Oh. You ever had somebody lie to you, and you know they lying to you? Mm-hmm. Why you listen to them if he give you the Holy Ghost? My kids come to me lying all the time. Guess what? Come on, man. You think I really believe that? You're only deceiving yourself. I used to lie to my parents. Anybody hear you lie to their parents? And let me tell you something. Don't lie to the Holy Ghost, though. It's unforgivable. It's unforgivable. And when a man got the Holy Spirit and he come to you and ask you something about your life, you better be honest with him. Or you might find yourself in a place. You'll be a walking dead man. Amen? You won't even know you're dead until you go be with Jesus. And Jesus says, I can't take you in. You're a worker of iniquity. I never knew you. Some sins will be manifest now. We will have to deal with some now. But guess what? Some of them we're going to deal with it at the coming judgment. Amen? And at that time, it's going to be too late. But Jesus said, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is what? At hand. He didn't say the kingdom of hell and destruction and death. He said, I got so much more for you. I got the Holy Ghost. Just repent. Amen? So I can give it to you. Hallelujah? Just get all the foulness, get all the ugliness, get all the uncleanness, get the bitterness, get the unforgiveness, get all the sin and the weight that easily besets you. Push it aside and reach forward to me. Hallelujah. Reach forward. Amen. Can I get somebody to reach forward with me today for whatever God has for them? I don't care. Like I said, yesterday is yesterday. This morning is the morning. What is... You have to reach forward to. Maybe you don't have a plan for your life. Maybe you don't know anything about God. Maybe you need a plan for your life. The Word of God is our plan. Amen? Amen. If we're not focused on heaven, then we're focused on something in this world. And guess what? That's going to pass away.
That's right.
And I hope none of us pass away with it. Amen? But he said, even the Spirit of truth whom the world cannot receive. You see, the world can't receive it. If you're still living for the world, you can't receive what God has for you. Amen? Because it seeth not him, neither knoweth him, but ye know him. Can I give an amen? Anybody here know Jesus? Anybody here know God? Amen? How do we know if we know God? Because we got the Holy Ghost. And I'm talking about people. If you don't have the Holy Ghost, ask God, I want to know you. Amen? And guess what he does? Ooh, here I am. It's that simple. We make it hard. Amen? For he dwelleth with you and shall be in you. This is a promise. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
It's a promise. Say a promise.
Promise.
It's a promise. Let's go to Acts 2:32. And Jesus. That God raised up. Amen? Do we believe that he raised him up and he's seated at the right hand of the Father? Amen?
Amen.
And he intercedes for us. We pray to Jesus. He goes, God, you hear him talking to me? Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Talking, Lord, he's talking to you. And he's asked me for forgiveness. I bled my blood over him. He's good. Amen?
Amen?
I'm talking about eternal salvation here. I'm not talking about what you desire in this world. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
See, we got to get focused off of that. He says, seek me first, the kingdom of heaven and his righteousness, and then all things shall be added unto you. Amen. If you ain't seeking him and things are getting added to your life, can I tell you what's going to happen when you choose to seek him? Everything that you have is probably going to end up going.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be burnt up because he never gave it to you.
Yes.
Why do you think relationships in our lives, when we give our lives to Jesus, they... Why do you think the things, everything I had in this world when I was a dope dealer and doing all these things, I had nice cars, I had rims, I had money, I had all these things. I had friends. Anybody have friends when you was in the world? Amen. Yeah, I had a lot of friends. Everybody wanted what I had. Amen. But when I gave my life to Jesus and I didn't have these things anymore, guess what? I lost some friends too. Amen. They probably wasn't my friends if they only loved me because of what I can give them.
That's right.
And are we really Jesus' friends if we only love him for what he can give us? Sorry to hit you like that. We should love him for what he did. Amen?
Amen.
We should love him for who he is. That he never changes. He's always going to be that same person that died on the cross for your sins. And until you're happy with that, we can't expect anything else from him. Amen?
Amen.
And Jesus has God raised up, whereof we all are witnesses. We're witnesses to that, amen? Now, he's talking to the book of Acts church because many of the disciples were there. Guess what? That witnessed him die, amen? But we have witness also. We have a witness called what?
The Holy Spirit.
Did you? Anyone here feel the Holy Spirit yet? Can I get an amen? If you feel the presence of God, amen. Guess what happens? Well, that's my witness that what it's saying is truth. Amen. I can believe him. He's not a liar. I've been to many churches. That man didn't have that. Amen. Guess what? Lord, take everything that I've been taught out of me that wasn't of you. Because that was man building and that wasn't the spirit building within us. Amen. And I guarantee you, listen, I guarantee you, what God ministers through His Holy Spirit is going to come against what you've been taught in your carnality. It's going to happen. In order to see the kingdom of God, you must be what? Born again. Hallelujah. The Spirit teaches us. You know, you need no man to teach you but the Holy Spirit. Amen? But God has chosen man. And I keep saying, why do you keep saying this, Pastor? Because guess what? I heard my whole life that it maybe wasn't from my mother, because my mother was busy, okay? You ain't never going to be no good, this, that, that. And I started believing it over time, right? The more we hear things, the more we believe them, amen? Faith comes by what?
Hearing.
And hearing by what? The Word of God. Therefore, being by the right hand of God exalted, Jesus, and having received of the Father the promise of the Holy Ghost, He has shed forth this, which ye now see and hear. We should be hearing from the Holy Spirit. Amen? Amen. A man that speaks to us from God, guess what? I'm going to tell you, he should have what? The Holy Ghost. The Holy Spirit should be witnessing on his behalf. Amen? Amen. This is why God has given it to us. Amen? Amen? As you witness to other people, you need to ask God to be doing it through you and not yourself. Amen? Amen. You ever witness somebody and the goosebumps come on? Woo! That's God. Man, that ain't even me speaking. That's you, Lord. Amen. It better be me speaking. That's what He says to me. Hallelujah. You should have been thoughtful about what you were saying and make sure it was me speaking through you. Hallelujah. This is why He gives us the Holy Spirit. Anybody want it now?
Amen.
Come on now. This is what He wants. He wants to pour this thing out for all of us. Hallelujah. That's what He wants. Slave, free, Jew, Greek, it don't matter. Woman, man, guess what? It don't matter. Hallelujah. He wants us all to have this thing, man. Because without it, we're dead. We have to understand, without this, we're dead. We're just walking dead people. What do I mean? Yeah, you're still alive here. You're still alive here. But when you go to be with God, guess what? He's not going to recognize you because He only recognizes His blood and His Spirit in us. Amen?
Amen.
Get away from me, you worker of iniquity. I never knew you. I didn't see my image in you. I didn't see my power in you. I seen another one. Hallelujah. It's important. The Holy Spirit is a very important topic in Scripture. Amen? Without it, none of us can accomplish the will of God in our lives. You see, let's go to John chapter 4, verse 13. John 4, 13. Jesus answered and said unto her, whatsoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again. We're talking about here the woman at the well, the Samaritan woman. Amen? He said, yeah, you drawing water from that well that Jacob made you, that religion made you. Hallelujah. Tradition made you. Guess what? He says, but the water I give you, you never thirst again. The true spiritual life with Christ. Guess what? You're going to be full. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't need anything from this world to fill me. I got Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. But whoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But the water that I shall give him shall be in him. For a well of water springing up into everlasting life. If we're Christians, guess what? We need to have this ability to say, whoosh, Holy Ghost. Is that what He says?
Amen.
Is that not what His Word says? You should be, guess what? Anyone ever get in a river and just stand there? No, it starts to move the deeper you get in it. Hallelujah.
Right.
The deeper you get in the river, if you get in a river that's flowing and you're just, see, some of us, guess what? Holy Ghost is playing in the water. Amen? Come on, let's just be honest. You want to still control your life. You still want the things of this world. You still want, okay, to do what you want to do. The Holy Ghost is in this place today, amen. There's a river flowing through here. You want to know why? Because I brought it through the grace of Jesus Christ, amen.
Amen, amen.
It's what he said. But some of us, I still want to live my life, so I'm going to stay by the land, and I'm just going to play in the water. Splash. Because you're afraid. Because you're scared. Because you're scared. I'm calling you out because you're scared. You're scared. You still want to control. There's no spirit of control in the fruit of the Spirit. Amen?
Amen.
There's a spirit of self-control, but there's not the spirit of control. I'm trying to get you to realize some things. But then there's some of us that, guess what? We walk a little bit more out in the river. Guess what? Oh, there's a fish out there. Let me play with it. Guess what? Something draws us out a little farther. Amen? A fish. A disciple. Hallelujah. One of God's children. One of God's servants. He draws you out a little bit farther. Amen? So now you're up in your knees. Guess what? You don't have to duck down so low to get it. Amen? But you're still playing around in the water. Amen? Some of you are by the land. God is saying, come on, come a little closer. Amen? Some of you were up in your knees. Guess what? He's saying, come on, come on, a little bit farther. So now the river's flowing, okay? You're up to your waist in the water, and guess what happens? Now you just can't play around in this thing. This thing's starting to move you in the direction it's going. Amen? See, the more submitted to God you are, the more Holy Ghost you got in you, moving you. Hallelujah. Where He wants you to go and not where you want to go. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Some of us, we up here, you know what I mean? Yeah, I'm trying to keep swimming. I'm trying to swim against the current. Because there's a waterfall down there. But can I tell you something? Man, maybe God wants you to go off the deep end. Why are you afraid to go off the deep end for Jesus? Why are you afraid? You afraid you're going to look funny? You're afraid you're not going to be as cool as you used to be? Or you're not going to have the things that you want to have? Amen? Why? God's asking you, why? Why won't you go all in for me? Don't you believe that at the bottom of that waterfall is the best thing that ever happened in your life? You ever look at the bottom of, you ever standing by the bottom of a waterfall seeing the mist come up? It's beautiful. Amen? But you got to get down there first. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
See, at the bottom of a waterfall, there's a lot of stuff underneath it too, right? There's rocks, there's land. Guess what? In that water, it starts to make room. Amen? And when you're fully submitted to God and the Holy Spirit, okay, and it's the living water, guess what? Your mind is overtaken, your heart is overtaken, your soul is overtaken. Guess what? Your spirit's overtaken, and you can't do nothing but move in the love of God. Amen?
Amen.
You got nothing. When the devil comes and stabs you, guess what? Love comes out. Oh. When the circumstance is dreary, guess what? You got nothing but joy come out. When there's chaos in the midst of turmoil, nothing's going right, and you got God in you, guess what? Peace comes out. Ooh, let me give that peace that surpasses all understanding.
Amen.
When you're going through the midst of the trial, and this trial is continuous and continuous and continuous, guess what? The Holy Ghost says, let me give you patience. My word says be anxious for nothing, does it not? The Holy Spirit leads us to God's what? Word. Everybody treating you mean, amen? The whole world's coming against you. Guess what? Kindness comes out. Hey, how are you? Goodness, gentleness, faithfulness. Guess what? You're tired. I'm tired of going through this. Everything's not working. Here comes self-destruct. But then yet, self-control comes. Can I get an amen?
Hallelujah.
You choose. It's your choice. How much of yourself are you going to allow the Holy Spirit to have? Amen?
Amen?
How much? It's your choice. I've chose to go all out. Amen? Jesus chose to go all out. The disciples chose to go all out. Amen? There was only one that was willing to get out. Everyone said, I'm all out. But guess what? Only one got out the boat. Well, let me bury my daddy first so I can get his inheritance and I don't have to worry about not having anything, Jesus. Let me catch this next flock of fish real quick. So, you know, I'll never go hungry. Amen? What about you? I'm asking about you. What's keeping you from following Jesus completely and totally? His word. If God has given you the power of the Holy Ghost to do this. Amen? I speak in life. Amen? I'm not going to speak a message that don't talk to you. Amen? My job is to get you to examine your life and say, you know what, God, I'm not where I want to be, but listen, I want to go up there and I'm going to receive this message so I can be where you want me to be. Amen? Amen. Today is the day of salvation. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's why the Holy Ghost is here. Hallelujah. He wants you to know I'm real. Glorify me. Hallelujah. Why does he keep saying hallelujah? Because all I can do is praise God.
Amen.
I've learned to say it all the time. Guess what? Life, life, life. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. No matter how things are going for me, I'm still going to praise Him. Amen. That's number one. That's what the Holy Spirit has been given to you for, so you can praise the King. Amen.
Hallelujah.
That's why we start a service with what? Praising God. Whoever didn't praise God, I'm going to be honest with you, you're not ready to receive this message. Because praising gets the flesh out of us so we can open up to receiving more of the Spirit. Amen?
Amen.
Our breath comes out so His breath, the Holy Ghost, can come in. Not saying you can't receive it, but to the capacity. Amen? The fullness thereof. Hallelujah. Let's go to John 7, verse 37. You need the space between John. Son, I know that computer. We got to do something about it. It says, in the what? What's that say?
Last
day. The great day of the what?
Feast.
Jesus stood and cried, saying, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. It's the last days here, man. The Holy Ghost is handing out a smorgasbord. He said, I shall pour my spirit upon what? All flesh. The question is, are we allowing it to go into us instead of our flesh? Amen? That's key. Are you willing to open on up and let Him in? Or are you just allowing Him to cleanse us? Amen? The Holy Spirit cleanses us. Amen? Jesus came to cleanse us from our sin. Hallelujah?
Amen.
Yes. But when our flesh is dead, guess what? Then it gets to our spirit. Amen? Then it enables us to walk and do the things that God has created us to do. Amen?
Amen.
So good. Point A is what? Cleansing my flesh. Point B is what? Renewing my spirit. Amen? My heart and my mind. Amen? We got to let it go. Amen? Anybody want to let it go today?
Amen.
Let's go. Let's go to verse 38. It says, he that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. From his soul. When God talks, I believe that when God talks about the belly, he talks about the soul. Amen? You can't live without a soul, just like you can't eat without food. Amen? Way to a man's heart is through his stomach. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Anybody want to cook for me? So when it's in our belly, guess what? It flows out. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I made a joke the other day because the scripture talks about bowels of mercy. What's a bowel movement? Amen? It's an excrement of something, right? You're letting something out. Amen? As people filled with the Holy Spirit, we should be letting out bowels of mercy, not bowels of something else. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When someone squeezes us, punches us, beats us up, guess what we should be doing? Mercy. 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 Not anger, not bitterness, not all these things, not gossip, not this, not slander. Guess what? Mercy. Say mercy.
Mercy.
Why? Because Jesus gave us what?
Mercy.
Mercy. He'll be just. We be merciful. Amen?
Amen.
But this spake he of the what?
Spirit.
Say it with me. Spirit. Which they that believe on him should what?
Receive
the Holy Ghost. What? Come on, this is the word, y'all. Do we believe? Amen?
Amen.
We got to believe in order to receive this thing. I believe. Amen. It was through my belief that I was released from a lifelong prison sentence. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I'm not talking about prison and jail. I'm talking about the prison of death and sin. Hallelujah. I'm talking about my eternal condemnation of being in hell. Guess what? It's because I believed on Jesus that I don't have that anymore. Amen?
Amen?
And it's that same belief in Jesus and the power of the Holy Ghost that gets me to overcome sin and temptation. Amen?
Amen?
It's the same blood that when I fall short, I can say, Lord, forgive me. Let us not use the grace of God in vain. Amen?
Amen.
For the Holy Ghost was not yet given because that Jesus was not yet glorified. When Jesus died, he gave us a promise. Amen?
Amen.
The Holy Ghost. You see, in the verses below, we see Jesus promised the gift of the Holy Spirit. Then in Acts 2, we see the fulfillment of that process. Amen? Jesus promised it when he was here, and when he left, the promise came. Amen?
Amen.
The disciples needed to be what? Prepared first.
That's right.
Right? Some of you guys got some doubt in your heart right now about situations in your life. Some of you right now are going through some midst of trial. They was on after Jesus was glorified on the death of Calvary. Amen. His disciples walked back on a road named Emmaus Road. Okay. And let me tell you what happened. They were questioning God. After all the miracles, after all the things they seen Jesus do, after they watched him resurrect other bodies, guess what? They doubted that Jesus was resurrected. Amen. And Jesus himself came and walked with them, and they couldn't even recognize him. Some of y'all got to realize Jesus walking with you. Just recognize him today. Amen.
Amen.
Come on, let me get a hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He's walking with you. Just give him his recognition today. Amen.
Amen.
Just glorify him. Say, Lord, I know you're with me. God, start speaking the word of life and the word of God over your life and start believing so that he can manifest change in you, through you, and around you. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
But guess what? If I'm afraid to speak, I can't even ask God to move in my life.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father.
If I can't speak, guess what? I'm never going to change. Never going to change. And if you're speaking turmoil, chaos, gossiping, slander, backbiting, guess what? You're going to reap that too. But when you're speaking life, love, loyalty, wisdom, knowledge, understanding, and all these things, guess what? God's going to give it to you. Hallelujah. You're a river of flowing life. What kind of water is coming out of you today, church? What kind of water is coming? Because Jesus is the water of life, amen? Life-giving water, amen?
Amen?
I just want to say thank you for allowing God to use you to confirm the message he's given me this morning, because I had two of them. But when you said, I kept speaking life, God said, you minister that message, pastor, because these people need life today. Anybody in this place need life today? Anybody need life today?
Hallelujah.
Can you put on the Holy Spirit thing at the bottom and just play it on low? You see, Jesus promised us the Comforter, amen? No, leave it on. He promised us the Comforter. Jesus prayed that the Father would send another Comforter. Jesus comforted us, but now he's given us the Holy Spirit to comfort us, amen?
Amen.
There's some people in your life that's been comforting you. Some pastors, some preachers, some maybe parents, okay? Maybe people in your life that know God and they've been comforting you and they're not there anymore. You believe they left you. You believe that they walked out of your life. No, maybe God had them leave your life so you can learn to know him better and quit trusting in man and trusting God. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Maybe he let them walk out of your life so you can get right with the Lord, so when he brings them back, you know what to do with them. Amen.
Amen.
Maybe he's taking some things out of your life. Guess what? So when he make him a good steward of the little things, he can make you ruler over much. Amen. Maybe you wasn't ready for the blessing and you went and got it yourself, and that's why you don't have it today. But God is faithful, amen? And even when we mess things up, God can turn it around for us. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Even when you mess it up, because God don't mess up.
Yes.
And he made each and every one of you. He didn't mess up when he made you. You tell that devil to get behind you.
Okay.
You're not a mess up. You might mess up, but you're not a mess up. Hallelujah. You might make mistakes, but you're not a mistake. Hallelujah. Would God waste his blood on nothing? Would he want to give you his Holy Ghost for nothing? No. He desires to give you these things so he can say, look at my son. Look at my daughter. So you can tell that devil, guess what? Look at him. Look at him. Look. You thought he wasn't going to be nothing. But he's everything to me.
Amen.
You thought they was always going to be this way, but look at them now. Look what the Holy Ghost is helping them do. It's a gift, amen. It's a gift that God gives us. And it enables us to live for Him. The question is, are you willing to choose today to live for Him so you can receive this Holy Spirit? He said, if you confess out of your mouth and believe in your heart, it's a twofold confession, church. And when we believe Jesus in our heart, we believe that our life must consist of a heart filled with the Word of God. Your heart, even as an unbeliever, knows the difference between right and wrong. What you can trust in and what you can't. What are you placing your trust in today, church? Lay it at the altar. Lay it at the altar. I was talking to someone, and God has placed this upon my heart. Anyone in here sick and ain't really received their complete healing? Come on, put your hand up if you have it. Amen. You've been prayed for? Amen. Things are getting better, but they just ain't done. Amen? Maybe that's just a sign from God telling you, guess what? You will get better if you just do what I tell you to do. Maybe you're so concerned about your health that you're missing that divine appointment for the person who doesn't have hope that's going to the same doctor you are, and God wants you to share your hope with them. I pray that bring conviction. Because He said we'll be given rivers of living, flowing water. Amen? It don't matter what I'm going through. It don't matter if I got cancer, I got this, I got that. It don't matter. If God has allowed you to get this, God is sovereign. Can I get an amen? Amen. He is in control. Do you believe your God is in control today? Yes. If your God ain't in control today, I want you to come up and receive my God. Amen? Because my God is in control today. Amen?
That's right.
My God says in Romans 8:28 that He allows all things to happen for the good of those who love Him and who are called according to His purpose. My Bible says that if God is for me, who can be against me?
Amen.
This is what my Bible says. Look into your Bible today, church. What does your Bible say? Amen? Do you have a word to stand on? Do you have the Holy Spirit to confirm that God is real in your life and to share with others so that they can believe in the message that God has placed in your heart to share with them today? I'm excited because I see a church, I see a people, I see a promise coming into fulfillment, and the devil tried to take it from me. But you know what? God gave me this Holy Spirit, and He promised me something in my life. Some of you guys, God has promised loved ones in your life coming to Jesus. Amen? Maybe He's promised some other things, but when I gave my life to Jesus, He promised me I'd be a pastor of a huge church. And it wasn't what I desired. It's what He desired of me. It's what He created me for. But I had to die to my desires. Amen? And for the last almost three and a half years, I've been through hell and back, waiting for the fulfillment of this promise. And I could choose to believe my circumstances, or I could choose to believe the promise that God gave me with the power of His Holy Spirit. What are you choosing to believe today, church? What are you believing today? I'm believing God. I'm believing the same one who in the beginning spoke and things were created. I'm believing the one who created me in His image and in His likeness. He told me to speak life over my life. I'm believing the one who sent His one and only Son to die on the cross for my sins, that I would be cleansed, renewed, revived. I'm believing the one that came down after the death of Jesus and promises me every day today everything's going to be all right, son. You just hold fast to my word. You just do what I tell you to do. And in time, everything will be all right. Jesus answered and said unto her, Whoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again. But whoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up in eternal life. In the last day, the great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, If any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. I believe that Jesus is here today. Is anyone thirsty? Is anyone here thirsty? He said, come to me. I'm not Jesus. If you come to him, I can show you how to get to the guy I know that keeps me filled. Amen? I can lead you to the one who despite what I'm going through, will keep me going in his will. Amen? Does anyone here desire that today? Oh, I can't hear nobody. You got doubt? You got discouragement? Lay it at the altar today, man. And I mean, when the enemy comes and tries to sway you to believe that God ain't real, guess what? Say, I left it at the altar. I left it there. I left that desire there. I left that sin there. I left that doubt there. I left that discouragement. I left all that there. So if you want that Satan, why don't you go to Jesus? Because as long as Satan can come to you, he don't have to go to Jesus. Amen? That's why we tell Satan, get away from me. Amen? Let us pray. If any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. If you are a believer today, it's just as simple as Jesus said it. Come and drink and keep drinking until you get full. When you get full, you will start speaking with other tongues, you're speaking in other gifts. This is part of the sign and evidence that you are filled. I want every head bowed and every eye closed. If you've never received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior today, I want you to put your hand up and put it down. I'm talking about fully and completely surrendered. Fully and completely surrendered. If you're just playing around in the water,